Hey everybody, welcome back to our off-grid cabin. Today is not going to be an update video. Today we're just going to talk about how and why we did what we did, both with our array, our battery system, and everything solar in general. So since this is not a solar update or a go-over of our system, there's going to be a couple links in the description box below, and I'll try to pop a couple cards up in the top of the screen for you. If you want to check out our system and how it's progressed over the last few years, check out those videos first or after this video if you'd like. The most commonly asked question in our comment section over dozens of videos, we've gotten this question hundreds and hundreds of times, almost every day, is why is your solar stuff not in the cabin? I've answered this question in the comment section before to people who've asked, but I figured it's asked so often there must be a lot of you that are wondering why our stuff is out here in a solar shed. And why, in general, you see a lot of off-gridders do this. There's not one simple answer for this question, but there's a few things that lead you to doing this style of setup. The first reason for us initially for putting our solar stuff out here in a solar shed was for safety. When I started doing solar stuff 4 or 5 years ago, we had zero experience. Last thing I wanted to do was start a solar journey, building a cabin, and burn that bad boy down. But on top of that, we also didn't know what the long-term plan was. So not only safety is a determining factor, but not knowing exactly what the end plan would be for our solar and where it would go. And I'm really glad I did it this way. But this is a mobile shed. It was originally located on the back side of the cabin. We moved it over here once we found the optimal spot for our solar array. Here's our solar array. This has been sitting here for 3 to 4 years now. It's been modified to, you know, and increased in size within the last year. But we didn't know where we wanted to put our solar stuff. So the short answer is versatility. We like versatility with everything here. We're not experts, we're not professionals, so we're learning as we go, and putting our stuff in a solar shed made it safe. So if something went wrong, all we had to worry about was the shed itself, not being in the cabin, and for versatility so we can move it around. We were focused on building our cabin. Cabin location and design is the utmost importance at first. The solar shed was over on the other side of the cabin. We had it over there originally for no other reason than it was close to our electrical distribution breaker box. The reason we moved it over here was for efficiency. Solar panels are better off close to our solar batteries. The closer everything is to everything, the more efficient everything is. If you were going to put your batteries inside your cabin and run DC power or PV power from your array all the way into the cabin, you would have efficiency losses. You would have losses with that. And we wanted this to be as efficient as possible. And putting your batteries close to your array is the best way to do that. So you might say, well, put your batteries inside the cabin and put your solar panels on top of your cabin. Well, you know, before we went off-grid and before we built this cabin, I spent 5 years at least watching other off-gridders do what we're doing now. And what we've been doing for the last 6-7 years. And I learned a lot from them. So here's why I think putting solar panels on your cabin is a terrible idea. So 5 years of watching other off-gridders and other people with solar brush snow off their roof, or having leaks from poking tons of holes in their new metal roof, or paying for expensive racking systems to put it up there to start with, was enough to tell me that I didn't want to do it that way. Sure, lots of people do that. I think putting solar panels on your roof is for those who live in residential areas or cities where they have limited space and they don't want to put it in their yard or they don't have room for it. So the benefits to putting the solar array out here, I could put it wherever I want. I could face it south. I don't have to design my cabin around the roof facing south. My roof is pitched and facing east and west. So right there, we would lose efficiency. We would have to have two arrays, one for morning, one for night. We have tree lines to get in the way near the cabin. We're out here in the open, and we can face the panels exactly where we want. So not only do we not have to worry about shoveling snow off of our panels when they're 20 feet up in the air, dangle on a ladder, or get a long roof rake, we could build this array for really cheap. Our racking system cost us just a couple hundred bucks worth of lumber, and we doubled our solar array as a woodshed. So we double dipped there. And I couldn't be happier with the way it's worked out. Yes, I have to come out here and shovel them off still, but I'm safely on the ground, 2 feet right there. I could shovel them off in just a few minutes. Sometimes you have to clear your panels multiple times a day. So can you imagine getting on a ladder a couple times a day, dangling up there and shoveling them off? For safety reasons, again, maybe that just goes back to safety, fire safety, but also stay on the ground with your 2 feet safety. Another reason we put our solar stuff out here in a solar shed, space. Our cabin's small. It's 400 square feet. We have about 120 square foot loft. We most certainly could put all these batteries up in the loft. We could. But we use that space for storage because we have a small cabin. We use it for guest quarters, and we like it that way. You're already limited. We don't have a basement. You don't want to put certain things in a barn. You want your household stuff in the house where it's safe from critters and safe from the weather. So space. Space is another reason we didn't put our solar stuff, batteries, in the cabin. So everything I just mentioned was important to our decision-making, why we put everything out here. But the real reason, 100%, we did not put our solar stuff in our cabin is because solar is not quiet. People imagine solar being dead quiet. You know, we eliminate generators in our lives, gas generators in our lives, so we go from loud generators to solar. Huge step in the right direction. But, I don't know if you can hear it, but solar inverters, not only are they loud, but they also produce a lot of heat. When we have small cabins, small spaces, we don't need extra heat. Heating up the cabin in the summertime when it's running, when we're charging, and I don't want to listen to it. Can you imagine sitting there eating dinner or sitting there relaxing, reading a book, and listening to this inverter hum all day long? Now, right now it's quiet, but we're pumping probably 2,000 watts of power into this, into these batteries right now. 3,000 watts. So I just checked my app. We're pushing 300 watts. It's 11 o'clock in the morning. We're pushing 3,000 watts of our 3,600 into our batteries. I'm surprised that shut off at all, to be honest. But this inverter is very loud. All inverters, they make noise. The fans run to keep them cool. But that's not something I want to listen to all day and all night. So right now, we're quiet. But here, give that a few minutes. It'll heat up again. Turn those fans on. It'll be kicking on and off. On and off. Not my cup of tea. So real quick, while we're here, I'll show you our secondary system. We've also set this up outside. We have our mini cabin that we've set up with its own system. This video hopefully will come out after we show you this setup. And listen. Hear that? This isn't just a certain company or a certain design or certain anything. All solar stuff is pretty loud. You gotta run fans, you gotta keep it cool. Sure, if you're in a cold environment, they run less often. But if you can you imagine putting one of those inverters or all-in-one charger inverters, inverter chargers into your loft where you have a nice warm fire going. The loft is probably 100 degrees up in there because the rest of your cabin's acclimated, or because the rest of your cabin is, you know, 70, 75 degrees, perfect temperature. All your stuff's up in your loft, hot, making noise, blowing fans all the time. So that's not something we want to deal with. This solves that problem as well. So if you have a basement, I can see putting your stuff inside. No basement, no solar inside for us. So big thing is the noise. Also, like I said, the heat. This solar shed gets up to about 100 to 110 degrees in the summertime. It stays pretty warm actually in the wintertime as well. All that extra heat, we don't want it in the cabin. We don't want that extra weight from these batteries. That's 600 pounds of batteries in our loft. There we go. Hear it kicked on again. So I've had people in the comment sections ask, what do you mean solar's loud? Solar panels, they're quiet. They just take the sun, convert it into power. Well, so if you're going to use AC power like a traditional house, use traditional appliances, you're going to need an inverter. That's what you're going to have to deal with. Now, if you're talking small-scale stuff, you have your whole cabin set up in direct current, DC current, where you're running lights and DC appliances, you don't have an inverter, you're still going to have a charge controller. Charge controllers produce heat, but they have heat sinks in them that put off the heat, so they don't have fans. So I guess the exception to putting solar in your cab is if you're running everything on DC devices. But you're not running a big system like this on DC only, because this is all 48 volt. Yes, you could step it down to 12 volt and use 12 volt devices, but we need this inverter to convert the DC power from our batteries over to AC power so we can run our cabin just like a regular house. Simplifies the system. I've seen lots of people run different setups where they have dual systems. They have AC and DC in their cabin. Sure, it's more efficient to have just use DC for lights and stuff like that, but you're talking twice the systems, twice the stuff to go wrong, twice the switches, twice the wire, twice the management systems. We just want our cabin to run like a regular house, and everything we need to do so is in here. So there it is. There's the big secret. That's why we don't have our solar stuff inside our cabin. All those other reasons are secondary, but the main primary reason, noise. I've said on a couple videos, people that, like I said, I've answered comments, they ask, why don't you put your solar stuff in the cabin where it's in warm temperature, where it can stay, in a more constant temperature environment? Noise and heat. People have asked me, they go, what do you mean solar is loud? What do you mean? Like, it's solar, right? Sunshine hits panels, goes into your batteries. Quiet, right? Not necessarily. So guys, just as a recap, here's why we don't have our solar stuff in our cabin. Safety, fire safety, but also design of putting stuff on our cabin roof, solar panels. I don't want to crawl up on my roof. I don't want to poke a bunch of holes in my roof. I don't want to have to get up there to install it. The expense of buying racking systems that are designed to go on roofs is expensive compared to our $200 worth of lumber here to hold these panels in. Also, the safety of crawling around up on that roof and putting the panels on. That roof was one of the hardest things I've ever done in my life, having that pitch like that. We did that for having a high ceiling in the cabin and also for snow runoff, so the snow slides off. Another reason not to put solar panels on your roof is for, if you're in the city, permits and stuff. Putting an isolated system like this out in your yard, most of the time you don't run into any codes or problems putting a system like this that's isolated away from your home. Put solar panels on your house or cabin, it becomes complicated with the city real quick. You could build a system like this completely isolated. How are they going to tell you what you can and can't do in the space in your backyard if you're just using it to for supplementary power for other systems, or for, say, you have an EV that you want to charge with a solar system. Run a cord right from this system to your EV. So it simplifies the system. Wiring this on the ground was really easy. I can take these out and rewire them and reconfigure them. I could replace them. I could do anything I want. I can monitor them. They're at ground level. So safety, cost. Like I said, it's way cheaper to put panels on a system like this, ground mount system, less rules, less regulations, and we can expand it when we want. I only have so much space up there on the roof of the cabin. Second, versatility. Like I said, I currently am in the middle of a project of taking this stuff out of the solar shed and putting it into our solar bunker. I hope that works out. I hope that solar bunker works out and we could put all our solar stuff in there and keep it at a more ambient temperature of the ground year-round. I hope that works out for us. If you guys want to check out that build, we just started that a few months ago. You can stay tuned to see how that works out. So you can subscribe to the channel and check us out if you want to do that. Our third reason, heat. Heat and noise. We'll put those together. Heat and noise. I don't want to have it disturbing my dinners with my wife and sitting around reading a book, relaxing at the cabin. I don't want to listen to this inverter hum and run and blow fans all day long. So that's the short answer to why we don't have our solar in our cabin. And I would highly recommend this system. I have no complaints about this. We're in northern Michigan. Yes, this solar shed does get a little cold in the winter. It stays about 20 degrees warmer than the outside temperature. A little warmer in the summer, but in the winter when we have 30 degrees outside, it's about 50 degrees in there. So it takes the temperatures to fall into the teens and single digits for us to have any problems with our lithium batteries, lithium iron phosphate batteries, charging. Normally we're in the teens and 20s, so we don't have to worry so much about this lithium iron phosphate charging in the winter. Half our batteries have heated cores, and then the heat that's produced from that inverter keeps that space warm for us. So like I said, about 20 degrees warmer than the outside temperature year round. Which is a bad thing when it's 95 degrees out. That's why we have to crack the doors open. But not so bad in the winter time when it helps heat that space. So guys, at an end note, lots of people on YouTube and off-gridders set up their solar systems just like this. And that's pretty much why. Not a lot of people talk about it. They just kind of do it this way because it makes sense. A lot of folks who aren't in the solar world that just watch it happen don't understand it. I hope that helps a few people. I hope that makes sense to some people. This creates a nice versatile system. It's safe. If something were to happen and catch fire, it's isolated out here away from the cabin. And we get to enjoy the peace and serenity that we came out here for. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it helped a few people and answered that most popular question asked in the comment section and on off-grid pages in general. But yeah, we use this stuff for real life. That's what I'm sharing with you. No testing it in a lab or a warehouse. Real life experience right here. I hope it helps somebody. And we hope you guys join us. Hit that like button if you liked the video or it helped you. And subscribe so you can join us in future videos and check out our old solar videos. You'll see how we progress through the years and how we got to this point. So best wishes, everybody. We'll see you in the next video. I hope.